Welcome to Daily Zohar. This shiur is dedicated to Ilui Nishmat Marat Savati, my grandmother, Aleha Shalom, Clara Batvida. Her yortzeit is on Sunday, Clara Batvida. And to the refuah shlema of my daughter, Eden Ayala, Bat Figel Sara, and for the parnasa of all those who support us and have been great supporters of the yeshiva, among them Ilan Ben Zion, Michael Ben Baruch, Figel Sara Bat Uven Lev, for their hatzlacha and success, and even greater success for those who will help us bring more guys to the yeshiva so we can spread Torah more. They will get even a truckload of brachot on top of that, because that's the most important thing. The Zohar says, Zechor, when we say Shamor, Vezachor. Zechor, who soda zachar, is hints, or the why we say Zechor, for the zachar himself. Zachar is a male. Ha'ochez kol ha'evarim shel ha'olam ha'elyon. That, again, don't think that there are male and female entities in heaven, but just rather a metaphor. These are all metaphors for those who understand what we're trying to hint for. But there's only, in Shamayim, there's only one entity, that's HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But we're referring to the Zachor as a metaphor for certain things. Zachar, ha'ochez et kol ha'evarim shel ha'olam ha'elyon, all the limbs of the olam, of the spiritual world, are being held together by that attribute or by that thing that is called zachar, male. So it says zachor et yom ha'shabbat. When it says zachor, it's for the zachar et yom ha'shabbat. We know that when we have ach is lema'et, only ach would be to lema'et, et would be lerabot. So zachor et yom ha'shabbat, lerabot lel shabbat. Not only zachor et yom ha'shabbat, you have to remember it is shabbat only during the day. Zachor et yom ha'shabbat. So I would have thought zachor et yom ha'shabbat refers to shabbat day, because it's a yom. But it says zachor et, the word et, comes to tell me to include the obligation of Shabbat, of remembering the Shabbat, because we have two, Shamor Vezachor. I heard a horrible thing recently, I gotta tell you. It's pretty bad. Somebody said that, well, how do you keep Shabbat nowadays? He says, well, I light Shabbat candles and I smoke a joint after that. So they said to him, what's the point of that? He said, well, I'm doing more of the Zachor, I'm not doing the Shamor. Al ze yikare shemo chamor. Shamor vezachor bedibur echad. You cannot separate between Shamor and Zachor. It's one thing. It's one thing that has two different aspects to it, but it's one thing, you cannot separate. So if you're remembering and not keeping, you're not doing a thing.
There should be smokes, he's not going to remember.
That's without a doubt. It's without a doubt. Shamor was a whole big joint echad. Now, and he goes, Shul Laila, so therefore to include the Rabot, to include Leil HaShabbat, the night of Shabbat, Shul Laila. And that's what it means when it says et. The word et comes to teach us that I have to include the night in the zachor as well. Shetzarich kedusha min ha'am kadosh ulitater b'hem karaui. Shabbat is holy by itself. Shabbat doesn't need us. Shabbat is holy by itself. But in order to bring upon something, we need to do. This is called Olama Asiya. We need to do something. So the Kedusha of Shabbat at night would come or is needed for us to do something for it. So therefore, we need that night to do it like this. You see that the Kedusha of Shabbat goes up, 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 and up until it reaches the peak of Kedusha, which is time of Mincha. Right? That's the time of Mincha of Shabbat. Shabbat is at its peak. So Shabbat graduates by itself. But the initiation of that here is needed to be done or started by us. We need to push it. And who is that? Am HaKadosh. But it's a dual relationship, like any other healthy relationship. Because the Kedusha, that we make Kadesh the Shabbat, in return, that Kedusha of Shabbat becomes the crown for us, that we are mitatrim bo. Mitatrin Israel behai Kedushata. The Kedusha of Shabbat, the fact that we make Kiddush, becomes a crown to us. So therefore, you need to do something. You're going to benefit from that. As we said yesterday, not everything that you see that you think is a punishment is a punishment. Most of the time, it's just a result of your actions. And then I said to you this morning, you're lucky if you get punished. Because if you see something that happens to you, and it's just a result of your actions, and you think it's a punishment, you think you're all okay, it's fine, it's just for you to really realize what you're doing. Then you need to make tshuva. But it's a result of your actions. So the Kedusha that we as a nation, as Jews, the crown that we wear on Shabbat is the crown of the Kedusha of Shabbat that we initiated by making a Kiddush. In other words, you want something, you got to do something. You want to wear a crown, you want to be, we say, Bishvil Kavod, Tzarich La'avod. You want Kavod? Good, work for it. How do you work for Kavod? Be humble. So, the Kedusha of Shabbat, which is our crown, comes because we were Mekadesh the Shabbat. And that's, by the way, the part of the Zohar that we say in Shabbat morning, right after Atkinu Seudata, right? You say Atkinu Seudata, right? You don't say Atkinu Seudata? Ma! You don't sing Atkinu Seudata? Okay. Yeah, they have to sing Atkinu Seudata. It's a beautiful thing. The Ari HaKadosh, his name is written on it, Atkinu Seudata. It's a beautiful, beautiful, there is Atkinu Seudata also for Seudah Shlishit also. It's a different tunes, different song. It's a davar chashuv beyoter. It's a wonderful thing. So right after Atkinu Seudata of the morning, right after the morning, we say the Zohar, right? Which the Zohar talks about the crown of the Kedusha of Am Yisrael, that being crowned by the fact that they were sanctifying the Shabbat himself. That, in return, becomes their crown to the heads. Keter
le'Roshab. Do we say Friday night too?
Shabbat Shalom, Kvod Hara. What, the Zohar?
No, it
on Friday night, there is different things, which is a very old, again, this stuff is very, very old. That's in Atkinu Seudata there is for the night, for the morning, and for that. But there is, and besides Atkinu Seudata, it changes all the time, and it goes like this: At night, Atkinu Seudata the Hakal Tapuchin Kaddishin. At Shabbat morning, is Atkinu Seudata of Atika Kaddisha. At Seudah Shlishit is Atkinu Seudata. I'm setting up the table. The Seudata the Ze'er Rampin. Okay, that's in Seudah Shlishit. But after that, there is a song to say. It's a beautiful. What are you rushing to eat? You have Shabbat. Sing the song. Belinda, I'll teach you one time. But there are tunes for each one. These tunes go way back, way back. So it's a wonderful, wonderful thing to do. You don't miss on that. You're missing a tremendous opportunity to give a little bit more meaning to your food. Don't rush to eat. Sing, that's what makes us different. Sing a song. Become more spiritual. Everybody wants to become spiritual. Everybody wants to become a Kabbalist. Nobody wants to do anything about it. You know, it's like, we used to say, put a CD-ROM, or, right, today is just an MP3 file in your head. You want to download an MP3 and be a Mekuba. That doesn't happen. Doesn't happen. It's avodah. As I said to you before, the spiritual journey is a very long journey. And I'll tell you that, you cannot do it alone. You need a guide. You need somebody to take you as children, by the hand, as babies. Because in the danger of the spiritual journey, if you go, you might end up in territories that you will not know how to get out, and you'll never come back. Or you're going to go to areas that you just don't want to go there. So there's nothing wrong with having somebody helping you make baby steps in the spiritual journey. If you want to learn, you learn. What difference does it make? I'm learning. What do I care? What steps I'm making? I'm in a journey. And I'm warning you not to dare to take that journey on your own. It's a warning. Don't take it. You're going to burn out. You're going to burn out. You have to have a guide to make sure that you're doing, first of all, the right thing, that you're not going to end up, God forbid, an idol worshiper. That's why you need a guide. So, therefore, that's the crown. Zachor, makom she'en bo shichecha. When we say Zachor, we're referring also to a place that there is no, the concept of forgetting does not apply there. Zachor, it's always there. V'shichecha ina nimtzeit bo, and shichecha, forgetfulness, is not there. Ki en shichecha b'mkom habrita elyon. In the place of the higher covenant, there's not such thing as I forgot, I didn't remember, and so on and so forth. It's engraved there. So therefore you see that the Kedusha of Shabbat of Zechor, how high Zechor comes. The whole Brit is dependent on that. The whole covenant of Am Yisrael and Kedusha Brichu, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu, is dependent on the fact that we are remembering the Shabbat. But we need to remember, and we need to keep it. It's two different things, but it's one. It should be done in one act. Almost lehavdil, if I'll be able to block and punch in one motion. It's the best. I don't need to waste things, right? So therefore, umichoshiken lemala ulemata, and if also up and down, because up and down, lower than that, right? Yes, shichecha, we do forget. And in a place that we need to, that there is forgetfulness, that people would not remember, therefore there is a need to remind people all the time that it's Shabbat. You need to remind people, because people will forget. How do you do it? You do the Zachor. Ve'al ze katuv, izkor avon avonotav. Right? It says in Tehillim, Kuf Tet, that he would remember the sin of the fathers. Ve'yesh ha-memunim, and therefore in that area there are those angels that reminds all the time, they remind all the time, zchuyot ve'avonot shel adam, his merits and his sins, all the time. Ve'en shichecha lifnei kisei HaKadosh. And at the highest level, when in the throne of glory of Hashem, en shichecha, everything is engraved there. There's no such thing as forgetting. Mashu lifnei hakisei HaKadosh, u'mashu lifnei hakisei hu zachor. So therefore, everything that is in front of the kisei, the throne of glory of Hashem, is in the concept of Zachor. Look how high, if now you might understand, when you are doing Zachor at Yom HaShabbat, to what? I remember Shabbat, okay, so the Shabbat is what? Zachor at Yom HaShabbat? Lekodesho. So when you are Mekadesh, why are you Mekadesh the Shabbat? Because you remember Shabbat. And now that you remember Shabbat, you Mekadesh the Shabbat. Look how high that concept can go. That fact that you, whatever you did, that goes all the way up in front of Kisei HaKavod. How high that is. I cannot even try to imagine, to contemplate at that level of what does it mean Kisei HaKavod. It's so beyond us. But it's so powerful. And that, what is next for me? What does it, effortless to keep Shabbat. It's effortless. If you think that it's difficult to keep Shabbat, you could not be so more far off from the truth. Shabbat is easy to keep. If you tell me to go to become a Navy SEAL, I'll tell you that's hard. Shabbat is easy to keep. The thing is, you don't want to keep it, then it becomes hard, but it's very easy. Even if you were not born into an observant family, it's very easy to keep Shabbat. Maybe you don't know, maybe you don't appreciate it. It's okay, but if you want to learn, nobody's stopping you from learning. But it's very easy to keep Shabbat. And this little thing that I do here, b'schut of the fact that I am keeping Shabbat, I'm remembering and I'm keeping, and I'm not only keeping, I'm mekadesh the Shabbat. I'm making the Shabbat holy. How? I don't care about what happened Sunday. I don't care about, you know, Jung Young Ul, whatever his name is. I don't care about the stock market. I don't care about the president. I don't care about anything. I don't care about my car. Shabbat. That little thing of my Shabbat goes all the way up to Kiseh HaKavod. It's ridiculous how scary this thing is. With no effort on my behalf. All I want to do is just lekadesh oto. And he goes, and why is that? Because that's called Sod HaZachar, the male, secret of the male. And over there, it's been a grave, the Sod Hashem HaKadosh of the letter Yud, of the letter Hey, and the letter Vav. Ulemata tzarich leitkadesh. You don't make the Kiddush up there. Nobody has grapes or wine, or no Shabbat was given to the angels. The Kiddush has to be down here. Here, down here, in this world. Ubame mitkadesh, and how you sanctify the Shabbat, that's what we said before. Bezachor. I need to remember the Shabbat. Remember the Shabbat to sanctify it, and you sanctify the Shabbat by remembering. Bazachor shemimenu notel kol hakdushot vekol habrachot. In that zachor, that all the brachot you receive in the world, all the kedushot that you receive in the world, would stem for and derive from the fact that you did zechor et yom haShabbat lekodesho. Your bracha is dependent on that. So you cannot expect to have a business open on Shabbat. Yes, to make a lot of money, but to have bracha in your money. If you're going to close your store on Shabbat, you might make less money amount in your hands, which is wrong. You won't. You won't. But let's say you would. But the bracha in your money would be as vast as the ocean. But if you open on Shabbat, no more than a bottle of water with a hole in it. Not going to be able to hold to anything. You have a lot. Take a 5-gallon bottle, but there's a hole in the bottom. You're not going to be able to hold the bracha. And he goes, Vezeu, Kshemitater ler Shabbat Am HaKadosh Karaui, Betfilot Uvakashot, Uvesedar Shel Simcha. That's why the tefillah of Friday night is so beautiful. When you go to Bet HaKnesset, everybody, we sing the song, Lecha Dodi Likrat, right? Mizmor Shir, it's very happy, we're very happy. The joy of the Simcha, the joy of being together as a Keilah, that I like him and he likes him and he likes him and so on and so forth. That joy by itself is how we start the whole process of bringing the kedusha about. Betfilot u'bakashot u'vesedar shel simcha. And if you would say zachor eino tzarich leitkadesh, zachor, I don't need to make it. I just remember it's Shabbat. Since she'arei mimenu yotzeit kol hakedushot v'kol habrachot shel ha'olam. Since anyway, just by remembering Shabbat, the brachot will come. The Zohar says eino ken. This is not the case. This is not the case. Why? Ki ze tzarich leitkadesh b'yom haShabbat. וזה צריך להתקדש בליל שבת. You need to make the you are sanctified by the day at the day, but you need to sanctify the day at night. So it's not going to, the Kedusha is not going to happen at all. Again, if I have a Sefer Torah that is holy, it is only holy because I sanctify the writing in it. So I need to have an action and I need to have an intent in order to sanctify it. So I need, the intent is the Zechira and the action is the Shmira together. That's how Shabbat becomes Kadosh. Yes, if I said Shabbat all day long and I haven't done a thing and I didn't violate anything, I kept Shabbat. But I wasn't sanctifying the Shabbat. And that needs to be only by remembering. How does it done? That's by the Kiddush that we do. It starts with the Tefillah that we do, Besimcha. It's a different, Kabbalah Shabbat is a totally different Tefillah. וכל הקדוש, when you do that, וכל הקדושות מקבלים אחר כך ישראל, and then after that, all the holiness is being funneled down. You kind of open the gates, of the floodgates of Brachot, by when you do that, all the floodgates come, מתברכים ישראל, עם ישראל is being blessed by the fact that of קדושת השבת, right? ומתקדשים בקדושת השבת של הקדוש ברוך הוא. And by doing so, they are sanctified by the holiness of not only the Shabbat, by them doing that, also the קדושה of הקדוש ברוך הוא. And this is how we become Am Kadosh, a holy nation. Again, יותר מששמרו ישראל את השבת, שמרה השבת את ישראל. More than the Jews kept the Sabbath kept the Jews. We become Kadosh, holy, a holy nation, when we keep the Shabbat. Your eyes would see, and no other, that when we don't keep the Shabbat, we are the worst of all nations. We become something that is unbelievable. The Kedusha goes away. I don't have to tell you what number one tourist place in Tel Aviv is in the world. Why? Because they don't keep Shabbat. That's why the battle of Shabbat in Yerushalayim is important. We can't give it up. We can't give it up for the sake of our fathers. And we can't give it up for the sake of our great-grandchildren. We have to keep Shabbat for the sake of the world. Because our bracha that we're going to bring down will help this world to make it into a better place. So Bezot Hashem, Yi Ratzon, that at least one time, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will help all of Am Yisrael. He would awaken that spirit of holiness in us. That we would look forward to, Kol Am Yisrael, Lishmor Shabbat Achat Ki Ilchata. Amen. Ken Yihi Ratzon.
Amen.